royals, Meghan Markle's family has been a huge pain in the proverbial throughout very public attacks on her and her husband, Prince Harry. The Duchess of Sussex has remained silent, but now a private letter from the Duchess to her dad has been made public. And to tell us all about it, we are joined by Studio 10's royal correspondent, Gavin Grey from London. Morning to you, Gavin.
Hiya, guys. Hi.
Oh, now, this letter really makes for terribly sad reading at times. Tell us exactly what's in it.
Well, you might say this is a right royal mess. So, anonymously, five friends of Meghan's, we think with the implicit knowledge of Meghan, but not of the authorities and the Buckingham Palace courtiers and stuff, basically spoke to the media, putting Meghan's side of this ongoing row with her father, her now estranged father. And then, of course, we get the estranged father hitting back. So Thomas has, we think, now released this letter, and it's pretty damaging in both ways. The relationship, it looks, I'm sad to say, almost irretrievable. So here are a few excerpts from it. It starts off with Meghan saying, "Daddy, it is with a heavy heart that I write this, not understanding why you have chosen to take this path, turning a blind eye to the pain you're causing." She continues, "I pleaded with you to stop reading the tabloids. On a daily basis, you fixated and clicked on the lies they were writing about me, especially those manufactured by your other daughter, who I barely know. You watched me silently suffer at the hand of her vicious lies. I crumbled inside."
Wow.
And then this last quote as well. "You haven't reached out to me since the start of, since the week of our wedding, rather. And while you claim how you have no way of contacting me, my phone number has remained the same. This you know. No texts, no missed calls, no outreach from you. Just more global interviews you're being paid to do to say harmful and hurtful things that are untrue."
Ooh.
This is a letter that pleads with him to stop, and it's heartfelt.
It is heartfelt. Broke my heart into a million pieces. You've got a feel for it. But how do we know she actually wrote this letter and his reaction, of course?
Yeah, I think it's that's a very valid question. We believe the handwriting to be hers, so I don't think many people believe this to be a fake. The reaction to it, well, there's no official reaction from the royal authorities here. We don't think they were involved in the discussion, the interviews given by her five close friends last week anonymously, as I say. But, of course, Thomas Markle has hit back, and he's basically saying in this letter, you know, "You said you tried to help me and send somebody to come and visit me to my home. Well, I was in hospital with my second heart attack." Mm. And he hits back at his daughter and then amazingly claims in this letter, you know, "Well, why don't we just have a photograph of you, me and Harry together and then give, I'm not quite sure that's going to happen, to the media." And therefore, he simply, consequently, you know, doesn't quite seem to say what she's saying, which is, "I don't want you going to the media in any more of this tittle-tattle."
What a piece of work. So do you think there will ever be any relationship between the two of them? And more importantly, will he ever shut up?
Well, never say never again. She's very damning in this of her half-sister, Samantha, about the vicious lies. She said she hardly knows her. Samantha's going to carry on. There's no doubt at all about that. And I sense so will Thomas, the father. So I can't see it ending anytime soon. Never say never. I sincerely hope for their sake they patch it back together. But, you know, of all of this, I'm sorry to say, I think the people who should be really looking to the laurels are the courtiers who surround the royals. Somebody should have gone out to him, gone out to where he lives, and tried to protect him from this. Now, I think they offered to do that, but then didn't go, and I think really they just should have gone.
Moving on to another royal scandal, Gavin. Is it true that Prince Philip is sliding into the passenger seat?
Yes, he has decided after the accident in the middle of January to effectively cut out driving. He's decided to hand his driving license in. We're still waiting to see whether there's going to be a prosecution on this, of course. But following that crash last month in which one person was injured and two others managed to walk free, yes, he's decided to hand his license in. But he's still, of course, going to have chauffeurs around the place.
You say he decided like he had a choice to make on his own. You don't think the Queen might have had something to do with that?
Yeah. I think that could well have had some effect. Her Majesty would be about the only person that he would listen to on this. But you know what? It's going to be a very interesting time now because he was always used to sneaking away when he could and, of course, driving himself. That's not going to happen anymore.
I bet. Is he allowed to drive around the estate by himself? Because that's private property.
Yeah.
So can he still drive around the estate and just not go on the roads?
Yes, he can, and I dare say he may well look towards doing that. They can't really stop that, so there are no other members of the public, as it were, on the roads. But I think this is a very simple move. You know, he's 97. There's been lots of people in Britain saying there's no maximum age to our driving licence legislation here, so lots of people beginning to look at that. But he can continue to drive around the estate, but on the roads now, it would be illegal for him to do so. Though I can't see him catching public transport somehow just yet.
No oyster card. I was just wondering what was going through Michelle and Barack Obama's mind when he was actually in the driving seat. Your boys in the front, girls in the back. What? I'd just love to know what they really thought of as he's driving around.
Yes, 2016 in Windsor Castle, that was, or to Windsor Castle. I would be delighted to know. It'll be a fly on the wall and a bug there to find out what was said. I imagine there were a few sort of glints as he got a bit near the curb at times.
All right, Gavin Grey, thank you so much for your royal update. Always a pleasure.
Thanks, Gavin.
Good morning.
Cheers, guys.